वेलकम टू DSEJ होम क्लासेस एन अटेम्प्ट टू कनेक्ट लर्नर विद इंस्ट्रक्टर ए डिजिटल इनिशिएटिव बाय डायरेक्टरेट ऑफ स्कूल एजुकेशन जम्मू माई सेल्फ साबिर हुसैन टीचर GHSS पुंछ डियर स्टूडेंट्स एज वी नो इंडिया इज ए लैंड ऑफ डिविनिटी The world has recognized India as a spiritual supremo, as Indian culture is laid on the foundation of its beliefs, values, and understanding that spirituality comes from realization and understanding of the self and that of the surroundings. The India has always been flooded with many great meditators and religious leaders. One of these greatest philosophers and spiritual teachers we are going to read and listen in this class is Gautam Buddha. Dear students, the prose I am going to teach you is lesson number 5 of your textbook Tulip series for class 10th. The Sermon at Benares. Do you know what is a sermon? A sermon is a discourse for the purpose of religious instructions or exhortation, especially on a text of scripture and delivered by a member of the clergy as part of a religious service. Introduction. The Buddha was a philosopher, mendicant, meditator, spiritual teacher, and religious leader. Who lived in ancient India. He is revered as the founder of the world religion of Buddhism. Gautam Buddha, 569 BC to 483 BC. He was born in a royal family. At the age of 12, he was sent away for schooling in the Hindu sacred scriptures and 4 years later he returned home to marry a princess. He had a son. For about 10 years they passed a happy married life. However, when he was 25, heretofore shielded from the sufferings of the world, while out hunting chanced upon a sick man, then an aged man, then a funeral procession, and finally a monk begging for alms. These sights made him so sad that he decided to renounce the worldly pleasures. He left his royal family and became a beggar and went out into the world to seek enlightenment. He wandered for 7 years in search of wisdom and truth and finally sat down under a fig tree where he vowed to stay until enlightenment came. Enlightened after 7 days, he renamed the tree the Bo tree, tree of wisdom, and began to teach and share his new understandings. He became known Buddha, which means enlightened. Buddha gave his first sermon at Benares, situated on the banks of Gangas. His first sermon reflects the wisdom about one inscrutable kind of suffering, that is death. Here the Buddha tells about the universality of death, which is inevitable and one cannot be escaped. There is another character, Kisa Gotami, who had an only son. One day her son died. She wanted her child to become alive again. She wanted some medicine to bring her son to life. People called her mad. At last, she came across a man who advised her to meet Buddha. She approached him with a request to give her medicine so that her only son could live again. After
deep thought, Buddha asked her to bring a handful of mustard seeds, but added that there was a condition. She must bring it from a house where no one had died. Kisa Gautami went door to door, but she could not find a home where nobody had died. By evening, she became weary and hopeless. She saw the lights of the city. Soon, there was darkness of the night. Now, she considered the fate of man and realized that death is inevitable and no one can escape it. She came back to Buddha and asked for his blessings. The Buddha, in his sermon, told her that life is full of pain and suffering. Everybody who takes breath has to die one day. The vessel made by the potter has to break one day. In the same way, everybody has to die because death spares none. A father cannot save his son from death. Everyone grieves when someone dear dies, but grieving cannot bring the dead back to life. So, death and sufferings are unavoidable. The wise person do not grieve as they know the truth. Weeping does not bring peace to the mind. On the other hand, a person's pain becomes greater by grieving. His body also suffers. One who has learnt to control his grief shall have peace of mind. That person is blessed who has overcome his sorrows. Dear students, this is all about the sermon at Banaras. Hope you have enjoyed the sermon. Thank you. Stay home, stay safe.